Let's have a look at two new APIs for scroll views in iOS 18 to, first of all, read the current scroll view offset, or in other words, which view is currently displayed at the top or bottom of your scroll view. And then a second API to define where the scroll view starts from. So where is the origin of your content? First of all, let me quickly go over the setup here. So there's a bunch of commented out code that we will add in throughout the video, but I will keep it commented out for now in order for you to understand what's going on. So we have a list or an array of different items that all have a title, which is just a string name of a color. And then they also have an ID in order to be identifiable, which is required for these new APIs. Next, we have a scroll view with a lazy V stack. This is unfortunately required as you will need a scroll target layout view modifier. Of course, you could also use VStack, HStack, and so on. And in there we have a for each over our items, and this is why the item is identifiable in the first case, but then it is needed as well in other locations throughout this piece of code here. Then for all of the items, we just display their color with a height of 200, and then overlay both the item's title, so the color name, and then their UUID. We're doing this just for demonstration purposes, and you will understand why in just a second. So first of all, in order to read the position of a scroll view, we need to add the scroll target layout to the layout container that is inside our scroll view. So in this example, the lazy V stack is the scroll target layout. This makes sense if you think about the layout protocol and how V stack and so on conform to this protocol. But this is the first view modifier that we need. Next, we need to define a state variable that can hold our scroll position. And in this example, I'm defining it for an ID type. This is a very fancy way of saying UUID. So I'm saying the type item has a type ID. What is this ID? This is the generic over the identifiable protocol, or the generic that the identifiable protocol is based on. So in the case of this struct here, it will be basically a type alias for UUID. So we could replace this with just UUID. But for reading purposes, I think item.id is actually nicer. So define this scroll position state variable, and then we can use the scroll position view modifier on our scroll view. This is important. This isn't supposed to go inside the scroll view or outside of the scroll view. This view modifier is supposed to modify the scroll view itself. In there, we pass a binding to our scroll position state, and then we can define an anchor. So this means that we are reading the scroll position from the topmost edge. In comparison, we could also say the anchor is bottom or center. I will keep it to top for now. And then we'll also, just for demonstration purposes, add a text here that displays the UUID debug description. So basically the UUID that we defined for each of these views. So now if we start scrolling, you will notice that the text changes to 5F8, which is the UUID of the red box. Then we continue scrolling, it will change to 91A991. So this is the green box and so on. So as we scroll, of course, this UUID changes. Then we could quickly demonstrate the bottom anchor. So starting here, it will be the ID of the orange box. Continue scrolling, it will be the ID of the mid box. So I think this is very straightforward. And then there is a second view modifier that I find particularly interesting, and that's the default scroll anchor. And the default value for this is actually top, which means that the scroll view will start at the top, or start showing the first view on screen, the topmost view on screen. This is the default behavior that you probably already know. But for other apps, like a messaging app, for example, you always want the bottommost view to be on screen. So here you can say default scroll anchor to be the bottom. And this way the scroll view, without me scrolling anyway, or without me scrolling at all, it will show the mint color here at the bottom. And then we have to scroll up in order to see red and green. Of course, you could also define this as center or any other unit point. But I think top and bottom are the two values that you will most probably use. I also have another video going into paging your scrolling with SwiftUI Scrolling and scroll target layout. if you're interested in that, make sure to click on the screen here as I've linked it for you. See you in the next one.